really moved by charity. And out of his faith, his belief, he tried to develop a real care for people in need. He became a very famous man in the care for poor people here in Ghent, in the city of Ghent. And together with him, he asked sisters and brothers to become sisters and brothers of charity, to take also care for the poor people. He was really at the beginning of our life story. He is at the origin of our charism. He was a man who opened himself for the gift of the Holy Spirit. He was a man who was spontaneously, I should say, moved by the situation of others, but that was what was used by the Holy Spirit to become very fruitful for others, for many. And it is in that way that he started in 807 the Brothers of Charity, to take care for poor people out of the gospel, out of the love of God. And he gave to us as Brothers of Charity a very nice text out of the gospel: God is love, Deus caritas est. And that became really, I should say, our motivation. When we have to take care for others, it is always out of that statement, really, we have to show that God is love also for you. When we see Father Trist working very hard for the well-being of the poor people, we have to know that it is the result of a real spiritual life. Trist developed for himself a very deep spiritual life, especially in the period that he was an underground priest in Ronse. For 5 years, he had not the possibility to work openly as a priest. At that time, he didn't waste his time, but on the contrary, he used his time to pray, to meditate, to develop a deep spirituality. From that time, we have his Order of the Day, and we are impressed to see how he tried to find a good balance in praying the rosary, studying the Bible, celebrating Eucharist, meditating, examination of conscience. This became all, I should say, ingredients of his prayer life. And when we look to that Order of the Day, and afterwards we see our own congregation, we really see that he gave his experience of prayer life to us, his brothers. He asked us to start our day with meditation, contemplation. He was very clear about it. He said, a brother who is not praying is like a soldier without weapons, is like a city without a rampart. He said, we have to pray constantly. Like in the temple, when you have the fire in the temple, you have to give from time to time wood, so it can continue to burn. So it was his vision about prayer, pray constantly. He tried to develop the prayer of the church. And we also, as Brothers of Charity, we are praying the prayer of the church in the morning, at noon, in the evening. We are celebrating Eucharist every day. And we really see and understand that the Eucharist is a very important point, that we can really meet Jesus directly. Father Trist said, Eucharist is a sacrament of love. It is there that Jesus is coming present in our life, in whole reality. He had a very nice picture about it. He said, when Jesus became man, then he lost, we can say, his divinity to become human. He said, when he gave himself in the Holy Sacrament of the Eucharist, he lost even humanity to become present in the Holy Sacrament of the Eucharist. A very nice picture of Father Trist about Eucharist, about the sacrament of love. It is very important that you develop from time to time the examination of conscience. You think about what you are doing and always to refer to Jesus, to the gospel, if you are on the good direction. We saw that Rist was reading the Bible, New Testament, Old Testament. We see it in his homilies, how many references he is using out of the Bible. He asked to the brothers, read the Bible, live really out of the vision and of the Bible. And also, he developed a real marital devotion. Mary, the mother of God, was a real, I should say, intercession between himself and Jesus. To Jesus through Mary. That became also, we may say, part of our prayer life. Every day we pray the rosary. And finally, for him was very important, the devotion to the Sacred Heart. It was of course linked to the time. At that time the devotion to the Sacred Heart became very popular. But for Trist again, the Sacred Heart was a sign of love. And for him really, the devotion to the Sacred Heart was the devotion to the love of God. So that was, I think, very important that we receive such a clear vision of our founder about our contemplative life. He said, yes, you are apostolic brothers, but you can only become an apostolic brother if you start with contemplation. Otherwise, we are social workers. Indeed, we are doing social work, but we are doing that work out of a deep spirituality, out of a deep contemplation. Therefore, in our life, these are really the two elements who we have to find a good balance between them. We have to pray, we have to work. We cannot do our work well if we don't pray very well. In that sense, is Father Trist very near to our patron saint, St. Vincent de Paul. St. Vincent de Paul said, when you are praying and you have to pray every day, you have to start your day with prayer, okay. When there is someone knocking at the door, a poor man, and asking for help, go help him. Leave your prayer. Or better, he said, continue your prayer. Because Jesus, who is present in the chapel, in the Holy Sacrament, Jesus is also present in that poor man. So he said the devotion to the Holy Sacrament is continuing in a devotion to the poor people. And then we understand very well what it means. We have to pray every time, without interruption. And that is the question we receive from our founder. We are very thankful to have a founder with such a nice and clear vision about contemplative and apostolic life. And that was for him the new model he gave to the world about apostolic religious life of brothers and sisters, founded in real contemplation. Then we are ready to go with the love of God to the others. I take one prayer of the Father Trist about the Sacred Heart of Jesus. And you will see and hear that is really a prayer to the love of God. Most lovable heart of Jesus, because you ask for my heart, I give it to you. Only you are worthy of it, and only you can make it happy. I give it to you so that you may heal it of all its wounds. Wounds of pride, selfish love, attachment to earthly things, and of a still greater attachment to myself, of a lack of love for my neighbor, in one word, of all my wounds. Let no wound remain, except the wound caused by your love. Jesus Christ, my God, I desire but one thing, a place in your heart.